All right, Mark.
Hello.
Hey.
Hey. We are here at Calgary Central Sportsplex here in Northeast Calgary. Mm-hmm. A lot of action is going on right behind us.
Yeah.
It's the sport of ball hockey. Mm-hmm. So tell us, what is the sport of ball hockey?
Yeah, it's really simple. It's what you can see right here. We use hockey balls instead of a puck, and we play on a hard surface that kids can run on instead of skate.
Now, how is it different from ice hockey?
The biggest difference is the ball and shoes instead. It's a lot more accessible for kids and adults both to be able to play in it. You don't have to learn how to skate first. So it's a lot easier to learn and pick up.
What are some slight differences in the rules with ball hockey?
One of the biggest differences you'll notice is that ball hockey is a lot more non-contact than ice hockey. When you start playing at more of a competitive level, there's what's called a floating blue line. So it's a bit of a change in how you can attack in the offensive zone and how much room you have to work with. Besides that, the rules are very similar.
Where does Western ball hockey practice in the city of Calgary?
We play primarily out of the Calgary Central Sportsplex, just 5 minutes away from Deerfoot Trail and Memorial Drive Northeast. It's quite difficult to find a place to play. Most gymnasiums won't allow you to use composite sticks on their floors because it wrecks them. If you see here, we've got a tiled floor, which is ideal for ball hockey. That's the reason why we do 95% of our programs right here, because it's ideally suited for it.
What are some challenges and some misconceptions that you face with the sport of ball hockey?
A lot of people think ball hockey is a plastic puck and they're playing with plastic sticks. Something that we're seeing a lot more today is we have composite sticks, just like you would use in ice hockey, and we use a ball that's a lot easier to manipulate compared to a plastic puck.
So when you go out and tell someone about the sport of ball hockey, what is something that you always tell them?
The biggest thing that I love to talk about is how affordable and accessible this sport is. When you compare this to ice hockey or a lot of other sports out there, the equipment is a lot less. You really only need gloves, a stick, and a helmet. There's a lot of things that ice hockey kids will be constantly growing out of as they get older and they get bigger. That's something you don't necessarily have to worry about so much with ball hockey. There's a lot less equipment, so it makes it way more affordable. There's a lot of kids out there that have tried to play ice hockey, but because of skating reasons, perhaps they haven't had the coordination to properly skate, and that automatically rules them out of playing ice hockey in a meaningful manner. A lot of those kids can come play ball hockey, and if they're able to run and move around quickly, they can still enjoy hockey without necessarily having to play ice hockey.
Do you find that there's a lot of new Canadians that come out and try ball hockey?
Definitely. Canada is so known for hockey, and this is a great way to get kids involved in it. Perhaps parents want to give their kids a taste of hockey without necessarily investing so much money and time into their kids in ice hockey, that they can try ball hockey instead, and it's much easier to get into.
All right, Mark, we've talked a lot about the sport of ball hockey. What kind of ball hockey programs does Western ball hockey offer?
We started out just primarily with adults. We had adult co-ed leagues, we ran a few other variants of leagues like that. A number of those adults said, hey, if you run some stuff for our kids, we would love to get our kids into that. So that's something that we've done now. So in addition to the co-ed leagues, where we have about between 30 and 50 teams each season that come out, we also have a new kids program right now. And this is something that's been growing at a pretty great rate. The adult program is for anybody ages 18 and up. Usually 18 to 40 is kind of the sweet spot for that. Lots of people in that range. For the kids, we're usually seeing kids between 7 and 13 years old in there. You can see a lot of these kids here right now that are playing. A lot of them are very, very new to this sport. And a lot of what we do here is more introductory level. And it's getting kids involved in some drills, and then we'll play some scrimmages after that as well. As our program grows, we're building this more into a league with official practices and games. Ball hockey is so small here in Calgary, in Alberta. It's just such a small program that a lot of what we want to do is get people exposed to it and have parents and kids feel like it doesn't matter what their skill level is or how athletic they might be. They can come here, get a great exposure to the sport, have a ton of fun with it, and not feel like they're out of their element.
How can people contact Western Ball Hockey to learn more about you guys and your programs, as well as ball hockey?
Yeah, if they're interested in learning more, they can go to our website, westernballhockey.com. They can also check us out on Facebook, Western Ball Hockey League, or follow us on Instagram at Western Ball Hockey.
Why should people try out the sport of ball hockey?
That's a great question. And I think the answer is because it's just so easy to play. It's so easy to get involved in. This is just about coming out and having a great time. And for the kids who are here, they have so much fun playing it. For the adults who come in, they know that they can come in with such little experience in it and know that they're among other people that don't have that much experience either. And it's a great way for people who want to be active but perhaps haven't had a great time playing other sports to try playing ball hockey.